Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will show you how you can undo or redo your changes from history within Photoshop. Let's say we have inserted this image into the Photoshop and we want to make the color of this flower more vibrant. So let's select brush tool from the tool palette and hold Alt from your keyboard and sample this purple color from here. Let's brush here for 1 and 2 times. So these are 2 changes. I will tell you why I did this. Let's brush here like this. Let's say in here I made 2 mistakes. So I need to go backward. So I will press Ctrl Z from the keyboard. And that's undo in Photoshop. But if I press Ctrl Z once again, then you can see it's just redo of our last change. So the Ctrl Z is essential when you are applying any effect in any photo and you want to see the before and after, then you can just press Ctrl Z like this and you will see the before and after of that change. But if we want to go multiple step backward, then how can we do that? We just need to press and hold Ctrl Alt from our keyboard and press Z 1 time and 2 times. That's how we can go multiple step backward in Photoshop. Let's go to history palette, which is here. If you can't see it on the right, then you can just go to window and select this. Then it will appear in your interface. So let's keep it like this and continue our work. As you can see, I am making the changes here, and every time I make a change here, and it's just keeping a record for it. But you can see if I change now, it's not making any record right now. If we click here, then you can go back. We can step backward like this. So it's keeping history for us so that we can go backward. But it can keep this history for a limited number of times, and it just reaches to the maximum number, and that's why it's keeping the most recent changes and losing the very beginning changes. Like if we go back all the way to the first change, then still you can see we have our first 2 changes and it can't revert them. So that's how the history works. There is another option in this history palette, which is the history brush. If you want to keep any change no matter what happens here, then you can just click that particular change and you will get that change no matter what happens here. If I just click here and make several number of changes like this, and you can see it has reached its maximum number of history, but still I can select my change like this. So in this way you can put this history brush wherever you want. Ideally, when you think you will be going with a critical area or critical changes, then you can put this brush before doing that, then you can go back to that step anytime you want. And you can also increase the number of histories. To do that, you need to go to Edit, Preferences, and Performance. In the History and Cache, you can see the history states, which is set to 20 by default. You can increase this number by the slider all the way up to 1000, and then you can press OK if you want. You can also put the value like this. And one more thing on the left, that is memory usage. It shows the available RAM of your system, the ideal range according to that memory, and percentage of memory that currently you are allowing Photoshop to use. If you increase this value using this slider, that will increase Photoshop performance a lot. I think 75% is a good choice. Ideally, when you are working with large files and applying critical commands, then you will be able to see the difference of the performance. But never set it above 85%, because that may affect performance by leaving no memory for other essential system applications. When you are done with this, then you can click OK. So that's all for this lesson. Hope to see you guys in the next lesson. Thanks for watching.